What is up again? It's your boy Lil C back with another video, you feel me? So I'ma just get straight into it like I always do, you feel me? Like, you know, I had a all in my comments. Every big video that I've done, I had these little people comment, you know, and people should say, you know, don't worry about the comments and all that, you feel me? And tell the truth, I don't really be caring about it, you feel me? But, you know, I like to address things because that's just the type of person I am. So let's you know, talk about it, you feel me? So somebody wrote in one of my comments, he gay is F, you feel me? The F word. So, you know, let's speak on it. Am I gay? If I was, like, why does it matter to anybody that's watching any, you know what I'm saying? Watching any of my videos, you feel me? Plus, you know, half these dudes that be commenting, if I was in their face, it wouldn't be the same thing. The same energy that they have to comment ignorance, you know, it wouldn't be. You know, it wouldn't be the same thing. You know what I'm saying? So, what I have to say about homosexuality is, you know, you can be gay today and give your life to Christ tomorrow. You feel me? Because, see, if I'm not gonna bash homosexuals, then this is what I'm gonna say. Because, you know, this perception of what a man is has been so bastardized that I can understand certain men just not knowing what being a man is. You feel me? A man own up to his mistakes. You feel what I'm saying? So, in the same token, I've been married for 7 years. I've always been with a female. Now, in my younger years, you know, due to me being molested by a female when I was young, you know, let's talk about it. You feel me? I grew up confused sexually as a child. But as an adult, you know, I've even stayed with a homosexual man because I didn't have anywhere to stay. And, you know, God is my witness, my wife is my witness, because that's when I met the dude, I was literally in a relationship with her. You feel what I'm saying? Walking to her mom's crib, this and that. And then one day, I was staying with my brother, and then I left. And then I really didn't have nowhere to go. And I got to the point because I was trying to finish school, you know, get my education, high school diploma, that I had, I didn't have nowhere to stay. You know what I'm saying? So I had went to it's like a shelter for men called the Salvation Army. And as I had, you know, went in there, a dude was in the parking lot. You feel what I'm saying? Like I said, let's talk about it. See, everybody wanna talk about me and what if I let those things hurt my feelings? But nah, we gonna talk about it. So I meet this dude. He like, man, I'm telling him, you know, I'm trying to get in school and stuff like that. You feel me? And you know, he looking like, you know, if you stay here, and anybody who has ever been to a Salvation Army, like I said, it's like a men's shelter. You can attest to what I'm saying. Unless he was lying. You feel what I'm saying? So he was like, they gonna, you know, basically make you stay in there for 30 days without leaving. And I was trying to finish school. So I'm looking like, all right, he seemed cool, you feel what I'm saying? Stuff like that. Long story short, you know, I went to his house, you know, like I said, who is my wife today? I called her just in case, you know, I had to, you know, do something, because I was feeling a little, you know, odd about the whole situation, like if I had to kill this dude or something. So, you know, long story short, you know, he knew this other gay dude that everybody was saying, you know, he had AIDS because he got real sick, got skinny, and, you know, it was crazy that he knew him because he used to call, the skinny dude used to call me nephew, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I'm the type of person, I don't judge people, you feel what I'm saying? Just don't put it on me, you feel me? So, you know, I had stayed with him, and, you know, he never touched me. But, you know, when you dealing with this internet, niggas be on the phone, you know, they can say anything. But then, like I say, when Carl show up, there's no proving, oh, what they're saying is legit. Like I said, I can own up to anything wrong that I've done if it comes to me. But, you know, I stayed with him, and, you know, I was literally helping this dude, you feel me? Like, it was days we didn't even really have nothing to eat. Like, I was struggling with this dude, you feel me? Because I looked at him as, you know, who he presented himself to be to me. You feel what I'm saying? So, and everybody knew he had that pack and all that. So, what I look like sleeping with this man, and this man's body is deteriorating in front of my eyes. You feel what I'm saying? Like, come on, bro. You feel what I'm saying? So I get old and I meet this dude, and he was in relations with this dude. So now, and this information came right out the gate. So even if dude don't get HIV and dude really died of cancer, whatever the case may be, that's not what the rumors was. That's not what the hood knew. You know, everybody that knew this man. So when I met the second dude, because by this time, the skinny dude is dead. Dude literally had ashes in his crib. On my soul, you feel what I'm saying? So, boom, I meet him. So I'm like, if you knew, this how I'm talking to dude. He got, because he, you know, people try to make it seem like some homosexual people is not sexually aggressive and stuff like that. And dude was like, so we talking, he asked me, like, you know, when I'm into this and that. So then I don't know how the conversation got about dude, the dad, but then I'm like, if you knew he had this, why is you trying to approach me with that? You see what I'm saying? See people don't ain't never walked a mile in my shoe. You ain't never heard me express this. You see what I'm saying? So then people just create judgments off of what they think they see. But you didn't see nothing. You didn't ask nothing. You see what I'm saying? Whole time my wife is coming over this man's house. It got to that point to where my wife coming over his house, you know, we chilling. We like family. You feel what I'm saying? So don't ever come at me. And even him, still to the, even if he watched this video, he is one of my friends on Facebook. I'm going to share this video on Facebook because he know better. Because he tried to say that, because he had all type of company coming through his house. And they was he was trying to make up this rumor that I was into this transsexual male. And I could tell the stories about that. Like I said, this dude had people staying with him. Me and my wife would come over there. We hearing these niggas in the basement. You feel what I'm saying? To each his own. I cut the radio on. You feel me? Yeah, let's tell the real truth. You feel what I'm saying? Because that's what I do. You feel what I'm saying? Cut the radio on. Cut it up loud and proud. You feel what I'm saying? And to drown that shit out, you feel me? I ain't want to hit it. So, you know, the tranny had a little boyfriend, and he was like aggressive. This nigga is in jail right now, you know, contracting, giving STDs to a minor and all that. See, these niggas is dirty niggas. You feel me? And my wife can attest. My Johnson has always been clean. I went to the clinic you know, a couple years back, because she the only person I'm with. Mai Johnson is clean, you feel me? All my exes can attest. Mai Johnson is clean, bro. You feel me? So don't even try to, you know, we hearing these niggas. And I'm, at the time, I'm smoking, you feel me? So the tranny, one time, he wanted to talk. You feel me, my nigga? On my soul, we in the bathroom smoking. You know what I'm saying? Because dude ain't want us smoking all around this crib. Did I feel threatened? Did I feel, oh, he's going to try to take a hold of me and he's going to bend me over and do this? No, bro. He sitting up here confiding in me because I'm the only person that's sane in the house. Because these freaky niggas, you feel what I'm saying? He was getting into, he don't even want to live that type of lifestyle. You feel what I'm saying? So, that's what I'm saying, man. Been in some trouble and I done some things myself. But I ain't, don't put something on my name that's not on my name. You feel me? If I was gay, I would accept it, I would own it, and I will be it. You feel me? Now, why I'm going to preach, now we got to go into the real deal. You feel me? I'm only 27. I met my wife when I was like 19. So anything before that, I was a minor. I was young. But I don't let my mistakes make me. If I ever did something, I could come to the table and say, hey, man, I did this, I did that. So for people to, you know, somebody watching my video, he gay as elf. You know, hey, if that's what you think of me, then have it. But what is gay, y'all won't admit to. A man having long hair, that's a man adapting the characteristics of a woman. Men wearing earrings, that's a man adapting to the characteristics of a woman. You see what I'm saying? A man trying to be pretty, you get that from women. You see what I'm saying? You feel me? So, y'all, we don't want to go into what I think is some of these homosexual men, these gay men is tougher than y'all. You feel me? Because guess what? The thing why I've always got along with homosexuals is because they can own up to who they is. See? Some of y'all daddies is weirdos wearing thongs and earrings and all that. Yeah, I'm gonna put it out there. Since every little thing that I do is questioned or critiqued or, but guess what? I know that any sin that I have committed, I have repented. You understand what I'm saying? I have got on my knees and asked the Lord Jesus Christ to forgive me. And I've owned up to everything I've did, from stealing, lying, mistreating people, all that. I went to God with it. And that's why I could sit up here today and say everything that I need to say. You feel me? So I done had homosexual friends. You would have thought that shit was following me, bro. And the last time I had a gay friend, we was smoking. You feel me? And it was me, him, and another dude. The other dude, he was straight. Because me and him, we a hoop together. But he had a gay friend. You know what I'm saying? And I was just telling him, like, you know, I didn't experience a lot of things in life. You feel what I'm saying? And I'm saying God ain't going to hold back on you. All you got to do is repent and turn away from that. Saying leave it there. Don't keep going back to it. It's going to be hard to fight urges. I know that from drinking, smoking, masturbating, watching porn, all that. It's hard to get past it because of the urges try to knock on your door. See, that's what I'm here for. I'm here to help people. All black men do is try to discredit somebody and bring another black man down. That's all we do is tear each other down. And guess what? When it's that look at a white man come through and they got you against the car, they putting bullet shells into your chest. You feel what I'm saying? Ain't no war then. Ain't no bringing down nothing then. You feel what I'm saying? So, like I said, I'm a positive person. You feel me? If you watch the One Chip video, my family, my people that know me, they was laughing, cracking up. Like, boy, you funny as hell. Don't ever come at me like that. Because guess what? Half y'all that comment on my videos, if I seen y'all in real life, we'll see what's talking about. We'll see what you talking about. I'll show you how gay I am then. You feel me? But with these, though. You feel me? And that's something I could stand behind. Because I'm tired of people coming, commenting on these videos like y'all scared me or something. Watch this video. You feel me? Since I'm so sweet and I'm so... Nah, bro. I'm happy with me. I'm happy with my wife. I'm happy with my three kids, bro. Yeah, I done made some mistakes. We can go down the list. But it's a time and it's a place for everything. But y'all, like I say, y'all talk about what's masculine. Soon as you say something to somebody, then they say something back to you, want to kill them. How masculine is that? I have yet to see, I've been in Virginia for 7 years. I have yet to see a fight. You feel me? It's always boom, 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 boom. Ain't nobody throwing no hands. It's not because, man, everybody picking up guns. Nah, y'all scared for real. And that's on me, fool. Like I said, everything that I'm saying, I can stand behind. You feel me? And ain't nobody gonna check me or nothing. Daddies, mamas, grandmas, ain't nobody finna check nothing I'm talking about. Nigga, I'm not scared of none of y'all. No more. Yeah, I used to play that role. Oh, I'm so scared. On me, fool. Anybody watching this video wanna do it? You feel me? And people know who I'm talking about. I ain't talking about everybody. You feel what I'm saying? Family-wise, whatever the case may be, you want to come in my head, go ahead and do it. I got a phone. I have y'all on my friends list and all that. Just hit me up in the inbox. You feel me? And when I make my way to you, we going to see what you talking about then. Because I'm tired of all these misconceptions. Everybody got me misconstrued with this dude and that dude, and I feel like I can say, come on, man. When dude wrote that in my comments, dude ain't know my dad. My dad come at me the same way. You feel me? Like every little thing that I do is something. So I change it. Like I used to wear skinny jeans, all that. I ain't wore a pair of skinny jeans and 7 years, 6, 7 years, 5, 6, 7 years. So that's what I'm saying, bro, because it's all about learning as well what a man is. Nigga, I don't know when the last time I sagged my pants, bro. But y'all do that, and y'all think that's straight. That's straight, but when you in jail, that mean that you willing to get your booty tooken. Even when I was sitting in the cell, bro, I had to be a man, bro. Ain't nobody raped me. You feel me? Come on, man. But y'all get in there. And I had Christ walking behind me the whole time. I made a mistake. You feel me? That I get to, you know, future videos. But I had made a mistake. But then I started reading that word, bro. And then I became damn near the loudest person in there. Everybody looking at me, the toughest, roughest, biggest dude looking at me. Don't even know what to say. Stop playing with me, bro. Don't none of y'all know me. I done shook hands with killers. I done prayed with killers at the same time, bro. Right. But you so big and bad. Nah, you don't know what big and bad get you, bro. You feel me? So I come here, peace and positivity. I don't even say peace, because ain't nothing peaceful about what I'm saying. But I know what the Bible say about homosexuality. So guess what? If I was a homo yesterday, I know that I could repent for it today. And that's for anybody who watching this video that is a homosexual and you want to find a way out. You feel me? Everybody want to play me like that's what I am. Okay, I got you. I got the answer for you. All you have to do is repent. Lord Jesus, forgive me for this evil that I have put upon my flesh and turn away from it and have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, bro. That's how you go to heaven. But they don't want you to understand that. Because it's always, no, it's not. No, it's not. Well, guess what? Like I say, for unbelievers, I made a video strictly for unbelievers. You don't believe in Christ. Guess what? At the end of the day, you can say, well, in your video, you don't have enough lighting and this and that. But guess what? It doesn't take away from what I'm about to say. If you don't repent and turn away from your sin and have faith and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you will see the same. You will see the same God, the same one God that everybody else gonna see. You gonna see the same God when you die. So why not live for Christ? The gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. But the wages of sin is death. You can take that one scripture and you go find it. You feel me? So, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. But the wages of sin is death. So, you can throw spears, darts, and all that. But I got my armor on, bro. Like I said, nigga, say I'm gay, taking pictures from the stomachs, from the stomach up, like phone bad stomach. Come on, man. We know what you doing. You feel me? You in the crib struggling. You see what I'm saying? Just from that, I could tell what you do by how you do things. You feel me? Some of y'all is struggling. I just can't help it. I know. When it's simple. You feel me? Right now, like I said, I get in the word, read the word. If I fail, I repent. But, you know, I've been married for 7 years. I have never cheated on my wife. It's not saying that I haven't been tempted to. It's not saying that I haven't been tempted to talk to other people. But the word is what keep me with a mind full of common sense. You know, if I cheat, all it's gonna show is that I was lusting after a woman and now I'm ready to commit fornication. All it's gonna show is sin. It's not gonna show, oh, we wasn't equally yoked and all that. Come on, man, y'all give it up, man. Give it up, man. You in fornication, that's not marriage, bro. Give it up, man. Y'all. But like I say, what I do, a lot of people can't do it. And I'm ready to get the tomatoes thrown at me and all that. But if you gay, all you gotta do is repent, turn to Christ. Stop turning to your family and all that, because they gonna cast you straight to the fire. When that's not even what God do. I remember reading about Sodom and Gomorrah in the Bible, and the part where, because you know, some things I'm just not familiar with all the way, but I remember this one thing when they was trying to get the dude, you know, trying to basically rape him, you feel me? They wanted his booty, you feel me? But he was saying it is better for you to sleep with my daughter, gee, than for you to do that to me. So, you know, to think that I'm stupid and I'm a fool, hey, that's just what you think of me. It's cool. Cause I'm in a hot video doing the hot one chip challenge and everybody swear it was, oh, he overdoing it. I'm black, bro. We don't sit up there and throw whole chips back and sit there and take it. I'm gonna take it. What I'm supposed to do, be in a video like this. Steam coming out my ears. No, nigga, that don't have me running through the crib. You feel me? Because it's hot as hell. If you don't believe it is, you get it. You get it and do it. Other than that, man, shut up talking to me. Stop commenting on my videos. Y'all not about none of that. Y'all some internet thugs. Man, because it was a song that I had made up, man. Y'all some internet thugs, bro. You feel me? And I'm not even out here thugging, bro. I'm on this channel having fun. I'm from Gary, Indiana. I came from walking the streets and smoking weed and seeing crackheads, alcoholics, and all that. Like, start. It's getting old at this point, though. You know. And see, normally the old Carl would have got depressed, and now I'm masturbating, now I'm drinking and doing. No, I'm good, bro. Like, it's just. Everybody ain't gonna like you, and that's the way the world is. So, you know, it is what it is. Get your water in, you guys. So I'm gay. I know. I'm just happy. I just be me. The real me is happy. You feel me? I don't have to fit in y'all boxes. I don't have to sag my pants to show, oh, I'm a man. I don't have to have holes to say, I'm a man. I don't have to buy 30 cars to say, I'm a man. I don't have to show money on both shoulders to say, I'm a man. I don't have to grow dreads to look manly. Look like I'm intimidating. You feel me? I don't have to do that. I don't have to, come on, what's up, everybody, to say, I'm a man. But y'all gotta do that. So, you know, joke's on you for real. You know? I don't have to beat it off to say, I'm a man. I don't have to do that. Me being a man is following Christ and making sure my family do the same thing. That's more manly than anything that y'all talking about. Because guess what? One day for your sin, if you don't quit and you die in it, you gonna go to hell. That's something that I know. So I'm not gonna be entertaining foolishness all the time, bro. You know, it's crazy how this light stay going out in this house. And on this video, it just seemed like it's just getting brighter, and it'll go bright, and then the light not even moving. The light not, because I guess what? I plan to end and go to heaven. That's why I don't do music the way y'all want me to do it. That's why I'm not the person that everybody else wants me to be. If I want to play some R&B, well, oh, he playing Keisha Cole. Oh, he gay. Okay, you can have it. You can have it. If I play Chris Brown, I'm gay. If I do this, I'm gay. I don't have to be what you want me to be. That's for my daddy, my brothers, anybody who got something to say about me. I don't have to be the person that y'all want me to be. So, there. I'm happy with me. Just know if you cross that line, just know if you cross that line, then, hey, whatever happens to you on the end of that, that's on you. So, peace.